This video explains how to install the FlexZone wireless gate sensor. The FlexZone wireless gate sensor is a simple and effective way to protect sliding and swinging gates. The small all-weather sensor module is attached directly to the gate fabric. Alarms are sent over an encrypted wireless link to a nearby FlexZone processor. The FlexZone wireless gate sensor comes in two versions, a battery-only version and a solar-powered version. When planning to use wireless gate sensors at a site, be aware of the following deployment guidelines. Each FlexZone processor with receiver card can monitor up to 4 gate sensor modules. You can have up to 32 sensor modules per site. The maximum distance from a FlexZone processor to one of its sensor modules is 300 meters or 984 feet line of sight. When selecting a location for the nearby FlexZone processor, be aware that the receiver card's antenna must have an unobstructed line-of-sight view of the sensor module. Ensure that there are no obstructions like buildings, trees, or other objects between the processor and sensor module. Locate the processor so that transient obstructions like passing cars or trucks will not block the signal. If unsure about the location, you can power on the processor prior to its final installation and run software to check the wireless connection. See the FlexZone wireless gate sensor configuration video for information. To install the wireless gate sensor, you will require Phillips screwdrivers of various sizes, a 1/8 inch slot screwdriver, a pair of wire cutters and strippers, a drill with a 1/4 inch metal bit, and a punch tool. The included omnidirectional whip antenna is sensitive in the horizontal plane. The recommended installation is to mount the antenna on the processor enclosure door for the greatest range along the fence line. The antenna should point away from the nearby sensor module at a 90-degree angle. To install the antenna, locate the center of the enclosure's door and mark its position. Lay the processor flat on its open side and center punch the location. Drill a 1/4 inch hole and remove all metal shavings. The receiver card is installed on the FlexZone processor's expansion header. If the processor already has a communications card installed, you can piggyback the receiver card onto it. Always power off the processor before installing the receiver card. If your processor already has a communications card, leave it in place, but remove the screws, washers, and lock nuts. Attach the receiver card standoff posts. Tighten the posts until they are snug. Align the receiver card pins over the expansion header. When aligned correctly, the screw holes will line up with the standoff posts. Secure the card by attaching the screws, washers, and lock nuts. Remove the nut from the base of the antenna and pass the wire through the drilled hole. To ensure a waterproof connection, you can add a bead of silicone around the base of the antenna. Connect the antenna wire to the receiver card. If you have the battery-only version of the sensor module, you need to enable its battery, which is disabled during shipping. Open the sensor module by removing its 4 Phillips screws. If you are using the 1.5-volt alkaline battery, place the shunt on pins 1 and 2. If you are using a 3.6-volt lithium battery, place the shunt on pins 2 and 3. Reattach the cover. Make sure you tighten the screws by following an X pattern. The sensor module is installed in the middle of the gate fabric. Ensure that the cable gland is facing downwards. Attach the sensor module with 4 UV-rated cable ties. When attaching the ties, tighten them against the middle of the links and not at any intersecting points. The sensor module includes an auxiliary input for monitoring a 2-wire gate contact. For information on wiring and supervision resistors, refer to the documentation included with the FlexZone wireless gate sensor. Caution: the contact closure input to the sensor module must be voltage-free. To attach a gate contact, remove the cover and connect the gate contact wire to the 2 terminal posts on the sensor module. Secure the wire to the gate fabric using UV-rated cable ties. At this point, the wireless gate sensor is now installed. The next step is to configure it. See the FlexZone wireless gate sensor configuration video for information.